Afternoon, Donavon Quackenbush, Midland, Ontario, Canada, here again. You go to YouTube, Golf Putter Alignment, Midland, Ontario, Canada. Just want to take a few moments to talk a little bit more about some of the research that I did. When I was doing some trials with some test putters, I exhibited a really odd motion. And what had happened is I was making contact with the ball, and the ball went away on an odd angle that I did not create. Because of that, I believe that there was a harmonic set up when the metal surface of the putter contacted the ball. It was either in the ball or in the putter or in both. The other thing I noticed is that it seems like, regardless of the putter head, it just seems a little on the light side, and it just seems a little bit on the wobbly side. So, having a little bit of knowledge, I elected to make some modifications, four major modifications. And this, I shouldn't say appears, it seems as if, and I wouldn't even say that, you talk about the term Cadillac and a really nice, driving car, it feels really, really nice. It gave this putter a really, really nice feeling. So I'll talk about a couple of things here. We'll just film it here. Is that number one is that I believe, Dave, that the shaft was ringing a little bit. So we basically wrapped the shaft, and that has suppressed any vibration in it. It feels really nice now. You don't hear it. You hear like a bit of a knocking. Doesn't seem to vibrate. I exhibited some of that before, like a ringing like a guitar string. So I basically call this like putter shaft anti-vibration. It's all wrapped nice. Number two is that this is the lie. The lie has been adjusted on this one from about 70 degrees to about 75 degrees. But I was a little bit concerned about the wobble. And it looks like there's a lot of things that are done on the putter itself, but nothing really about the hosel. So because this acts in a gravity, with gravity on it, we just go down here, gravity acts this way. I elected to put a test weight, which I think is probably about the weight of the putter itself, and it acts in the direction of gravity. So this does a couple of things, but it's on the shaft itself. So the shaft acts like the crankshaft in an engine, the center of gravity, a rotational, the center of rotation, let's say in the pendulum and a grandfather clock, the normal center of rotation, let's say on a clock. And now, like a counterbalancer in a crankshaft, there is almost no wobble in this whatsoever. The other thing that's really interested in it is that because when you have your stance and when you draw back for your stroke, gravity is now acting on that, and it has a bit of a preload, which gives you a really, really accurate, and this seems to have a gyro effect, which kills all of the wobble in the tip. Killing the wobble in the tip means that you impact exactly on tangent, exactly line of travel, and you get hole-in-ones. The other thing that really concerned me is I believe that there was also vibration in the hosel itself. The way you kill that is that you increase the mass a little bit. So if we look here, I basically call this hosel anti-vibration. You increase its mass a little bit like that, and then that's not going to want to vibrate whatsoever when you get the contacting of the ball. Last but not least, right, because of this concern I had with the metal impact on the golf ball itself, is I elected to go with a variety of materials. And in the good old days, lo and behold, the best material seemed to be oak. So what we did is that we took a little imprint of that, we cut a little template out, and we cut out, that's probably about 10 millimeters thick, that is then epoxied on, actually not epoxied on, it goes on with RTV. And now this is like the Cadillac. It's a very, very nice sound. There is no ringing whatsoever. Sounds really nice. Seems to give really, really good stroke control. Gives really, really good range control. Try a little putt here, see what happens here. I'm just gonna line up here quickly. Again, right, Day. Send this, we'll just align up here perfectly. And we will try a nice little putt here. And it's right on the money. Now, last but not least, is this is very, 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 very precise. So I decided a really good idea to work on the preciseness and just show exactly how good this is. For example, we will line up here and we will see that we have almost nothing whatsoever in the wobble. So I decided I would invent what's called the putter board. So basically the putter board, you take a piece of board, right? You mount a golf ball on here with actually a deck screw, could be a drywall screw. And then you go and you make a little countersink here that your ball can sit in. You put it on the flat on the carpet. And then what you do here is that to then get yourself very, very precise and get your muscle memory, then you basically putt from this golf ball and try to hit this golf ball. We line up again and we then, right, we putt to the other golf ball. Now, this is even more neat because then what you do is to simulate the green, you get a little piece of carpet and you put this carpet on here. There, you set your golf ball on here. Again, if you want, you can practice approaching. You approach, right there, you approach. You get approximately lined up. Same deal, right? You see you're pretty close here, but you can actually see here. Get yourself lined up. Might be a bit of tilt on it. And then you align yourself really, really nicely. And there you go. Very, very important. The last thing I have to say, I was talking about the fact that this is a little on the short side, right, Day? I don't believe it is on the short side, because what it does is that it gives you a really nice position, nice parallel feet. Again, facing 12 inches, putting a little bit closer, you nicely align, and then your arms can be in the perfect position. You're a little bit forward. You get this perfect pendulum position, a little bit near the ribs. And then you get a very, very, very nice. Oh, last thing I thought, not so bad, is that not the worst thing in the world is to mark where your thumbs are. Therefore, if you don't even think about it, it would just make you a little bit more precise. Each time you take up your putter, then your thumbs will go in exactly the correct position. That just takes one more air out of your putting. So again, to finish, right, we will go over here. And we will, this measure it to be exactly 3 feet. Right, Day. And again, we will measure. Looks good. We will align, step around. Right, Day. And you will get a nice, and that's how you do it. Thank you so much for listening. God bless you all. Have a nice day, and we'll see you in another video.